Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm your brother in Islam, Jalal ibn Sa'eed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, today I want to talk about something so special, purity. Purity. Pure. Purity is so important, ikhwan wal akhawat. It is such an important aspect of everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in the akhirah, I will only accept. I will accept nothing except qalban saleem, a sound, pure heart. The purest of hearts, my brothers and sisters. Any amount of dhan, conjecture, little bit of doubt, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rejects this. We cannot have any doubt. We must have yaqeen. Allah exists or He does not. The person who's in the middle is a fool. You're not benefiting here, you're not benefiting there. You may as well disbelieve, but you can't because you know He's there. So seek knowledge, learn. How do you remove the doubts? It's natural, ikhwan. It's natural, ikhwat. Don't feel like I'm a kafir because I have doubts. It's natural. Shaitan will whisper, we will have doubts. How do you get rid of doubts? Remove the shahwat, the desires, by fasting. Remove the shubahat, the doubts, by asking questions and seeking knowledge. Attend the lessons online. I'm online every single day. I don't know what time or what time scale where you guys are, but every single day you can find us online, youtube.com/alfitrah. And I'm telling you, every single day there are scholars online. You can find them on YouTube, everywhere. Ask questions. We have live Q&As going every single day. Don't wait for people to bring it to you. Because when accounts are taken, it'll be too late. Let this Ramadan be a day, a month of one, to really purify yourself. So purification. Do you know the action of ibadah is the fundamental basic accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The basics of Islam is that you pray 5 times a day. So anyone who does not pray is outside of Islam. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said. The difference between the kafir and the Muslim is as-salah. So if someone says, I don't need to pray, then he is not a Muslim. He chooses not to be. But anyone who says, I am a Muslim, he says, I have to pray. Astaghfirullah, I missed my prayer. I need to make them up. You see, that is belief, is salah. The most fundamental action is the prayer. And yet that is not accepted from anyone unless you make wudu. Unless you make wudu and purify tahara. My brothers and sisters in Islam, I wanted to just share this with you today because it's Ramadan. We're going to be making wudu many times in the week. And when you make wudu, it's not just water splashing, making a mess. No, because if you didn't have water, you still need to purify. You would rub your hands on the dirt and make masha. You would make tayammum. Do you see? Allahu Akbar. Even the person who's on his deathbed and it's time to pray, he rubs on the bed sheets and says, I'm making tayammum, and he prays salah laying down. Ikhwan wal akhawat, we're not excused from salah, but we're also not excused from purifying. So if we must purify, it's not about the water, it's not about washing, it's about the mind frame. I am preparing to stand in front of my Lord. I am spiritually washing the sins away from my eyes, the haram I've seen, my hands, the haram I've touched, my mouth, the haram I've spoken. Let me stand in front of Allah and repent. This is the beauty of making tawbah and the beauty of preparing to meet Allah Azza wa Jal. My brothers and sisters, purification also means clothes, looking your best, being sharp in your best whites. We'll talk about that another day as well. But just a quick note, your clothes, your house, every single thing you do must be clean. And the cleanliness is next to godliness. This is a belief universal from Tawheed, from Allah Azza wa Jal. It's in the Bible, in fact. It is a phrase from the Bible as well. This is what we believe as true believers upon Tawheed, that we must be pure. And purifying our tongue from spitting insults, purifying our tongue from backbiting and gossiping, purifying our hands from hurting or abusing family members and relatives and friends. The believer is one from whom you're a Muslim, he is safe from his tongue and his hands. This is a reality, a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. And the beauty of one's Islam is that he leaves that which does not concern him. Ikhwan wal akhawat, build this inside you. Build up this love for other Muslims. Increase the love and the khushu within you. Want to help others. Want to support others. And do it in a beautiful way. Keep the intentions purely for His sake alone. And I end this. No matter what you do, what intention, whether you're making wudu, tayammum, you are cleaning your house, your car, just say, Ya Allah, it's for you. And you gain sawab. You gain reward. Don't mention His name, you get nothing. The niyyah is everything. May Allah Azza wa Jal bless us, purify our intentions every day, 10 times a day, renew our niyyah, and may Allah Azza wa Jal grant us success. in returning to Him, and give us Jannat al-Firdaus, and may we all meet in Firdaus al-A'la with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Anbiya of Allah azza wa jalla. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.